And what the devil wants to trick you into doing is trying to perfect it through your works. Boy, if I could get five people to get this morning, I'd raise up the target people in the place. The enemy wants to get in your mind with sense. You know that can't happen like that. You got to make that phone call. You better go get them straight. When God said, listen, if I said it, I'm going to bring it back. So I want your hope not to be in your ability. I want your hope to be in what I said. The Bible says he against hope believed in hope that he would become the father of many nations according to that which had been spoken. Oh God, I gotta talk to somebody. Glory to God. What has been spoken? That you've been waiting 20 years for. What has been spoken? That you've been waiting 15 years for. Good God. What has been spoken? That you danced about and still waiting for. Where is your hope? Glory to God. When you wake up in the morning, it holds your hope.
Yes, God.
Amen. Amen. Shonda, where is your hope? Is your hope in your boss? Is your hope in your spouse? That's why every time your spouse or they do something, you think God done messed over you because of something they did. But God don't do it based on what they did. He did it just based on what he said.
That's it. That's it.
Boy, I'm preaching good here.
Yes,
God. So yeah, let's just talk about this law. So how do I respond? It says that we be not slothful, but be fond of them who through faith and patience. Oh boy, I should charge off this guy. I'm gonna start charging next week. I'm gonna start telling you right now. I should charge this guy. What's it? He said, be fond of them who through faith and patience. So what is patience?
Long-suffering.
Inherit the promises. Remember now, a promise from God is what? A pledge. An announcement. And then something you have to earn. It's like if I tell you, man, I'm gonna give her $10. That's a pledge from me. I can afford to give her $10. Okay. I didn't say she had to clean her room. God help me to take $1,000 and get to do that. Someone say, man. I didn't say she didn't do none of that. But if I call her $10, that means that's a pledge from her daddy who has the power to do that.
Yes.
So when God makes you a promise, you have to first realign your thinking to know that this promise came from God.
Yes.
It's not the preacher. He was just a vehicle. So I got to put my hope in the ability of God. God help me. I got to go back to faith. I got to have confidence that the God who said it is able to perform it.
Yeah.
My God, am I happening over here? And I have to block out here with this, the shouting stuff. I have to know that it's through patience.
Yeah,
I have to have endurance.
Yes.
When life testifies against my promise. When life testifies against my promise, I can't put my hope in what life is telling me. I can't put my hope in what God is saying. And even though it looks like it ain't happened, and it looks like time has passed, and it looks like everybody's rejecting me, and everybody turned against me, I gotta be fully persuaded. I'm preaching good here, y'all. I'm preaching really good here. See, there's no compromise. You have to bring yourself to a place of no compromise. For that reason, you have to learn spiritual laws. Lest when the devil tell you God forget you, you believe him. Because you didn't do something right. God, help me to get this out, Holy Spirit. I love you, Lord. I love you, Jesus. Help me to get this out. Help me to get this out. Lest you understand that you have this promise. The integrity of God is at stake. The church teaches the Holy Spirit. The church is before God and the host of heaven. God is showing his wisdom. The Bible says the manifold wisdom of God is being made known under the principalities and powers of heaven placed to the church. So God is using you to show the host of heaven how bad he is. My God, you don't hear what I'm saying. And what he did to you, he said, I'm going to promise you something. And I don't care what happens in the process, all I want you to do is believe that.
Yes, yes, yes.
God foretold Timothy this. Timothy said, man, these people are walking out on us. Paul said, yeah, they've been up from us because they were not of us.
Hey.
Because had they been of us, no doubt they would have continued with us.
Yeah.
But they've been up from us. I'm talking to you. So that it can be made manifest that they were not all of us. Destiny is never tied to people behind you.
Hallelujah.
People behind you don't live with misery. Destiny is always tied to somebody you need to